All data access in CockroachDB is transactional, which guarantees data integrity. Using the built-in SQL shell, let's take a look at how CockroachDB handles transactions. In this lesson, I'll first run a simple transaction, that is, a single SQL statement, and then I'll run two conflicting multi-statement transactions in parallel to see what happens. For the purpose of this lesson, I have already started an insecure 3-node cluster and created a database called Bank with fictional bank account data. First, let's take a look at what's in the Bank database. As you can see, I added two tables to the Bank database already. Accounts and customers. Let's take a closer look at the data in the customers table. There are four customer records in the table. I'm going to focus on the customer named Carl a little later when I start running transactions. Now let's look at the accounts table. If you recall from the customers table, Carl's customer ID is 2. The accounts table uses this customer ID as a foreign key to link relevant records in the two tables together. Let's pretend Carl needs to withdraw $50 from his account. First, I need to check that he has this money in his account. And he does. Since he has enough, let's make the withdrawal. Okay, that went through. Let's check to make sure that the withdrawal was made, just to be sure. You can see that Carl's checking account balance is now $200, which is $50 less than what it was. This would work most of the time, but there's a flaw. What happens if Carl issues two transfer requests for $200 at the same time? Let's call them transfer A and transfer B. Transfer A checks to see if there's at least $200 in Carl's checking account. There is, so it proceeds with the transfer. But before transfer A can deduct the $200 from his account, transfer B also checks to see if there's $200 in the account. Transfer A hasn't deducted the money yet, so transfer B sees enough money and decides to proceed as well. When the two transfers complete, Carl will have withdrawn $200 that wasn't in his account, and the bank will have to cover the cost. This issue can be solved by using transactions. If two transactions attempt to modify the same data after reading it, CockroachDB will block the transaction with the stale read. Let's run these two transactions in parallel and see what happens. To do that, I use the begin statement to start transfer A. Great, now the transaction is open. Now I'm going to check Carl's balance to see if there's $200 in his account. When I hit enter, it doesn't run the SQL statement. Instead, it starts a new line to create a multi-statement transaction. If I hit enter again, the SQL statement will run, but it won't be committed. All of the SQL statements in the transaction will be committed together when we use the commit statement later. Okay, true is returned, so transfer A thinks Carl has enough money in his account for the $200 withdrawal. We'll come back to this. Let's also start transfer B. To do that, I'll start the SQL shell in the second terminal window and start the second transaction. Now to send the SQL statement to the server, I'll hit enter twice. And we can see that true is returned, meaning transfer B also thinks Carl has enough money in his account for the $200 withdrawal. Now I'll go back to transfer A and run the second part of this transaction, which is the withdrawal. Again, note that the select and update statements that I just entered have been run, but not committed. This means that no other transaction can see the resulting effects until after I commit the transaction. Back in the second terminal window where transfer B was in progress, I'm also going to try to make the $200 withdrawal. And you can see here that there's no response being returned because the statement was blocked. Essentially, it is waiting to see what transfer A will do before it proceeds. So let's go back to the first terminal and commit the first transaction. Okay, so we committed the transaction and transfer A has gone through. If we look at transfer B, we see that we got an error. This is because transfer A was committed while transfer B was still in progress. Because of this, transfer B is working with an old read of the data and needs to be aborted and restarted. So now that we've hit this error, I'll use the rollback statement to abort this transaction. Great, now the transfer B transaction has been discarded. Let's also check to make sure that only one withdrawal went through. And it has. Carl's balance is now 0, which is $200 less from when we started the transaction. In summary, we first ran through a simple update statement to withdraw money from an account. We then realized that this situation was flawed because it doesn't prevent two conflicting transfer requests. To solve for this, we use multi-statement transactions using the begin statement. And when the transactions noticed the conflicting activity, one was blocked from continuing. Now you should be familiar with how CockroachDB can bundle multiple SQL statements into a single ACID transaction. Keep this in mind when deciding how to use transactions to preserve data integrity.